What are the major, problems that Kubernetes community is still facing that you still need to, because now it's getting into production, people are, so what are those?
The biggest challenge, I think, is Kubernetes comes out with a different way of thinking about the same problem, right? We have a lot of machines. Configuration management has its own take on that problem. Custom homegrown solutions has a take on that problem. Even cloud had a take on that problem. PaaSes have a take on that problem. And so when Kubernetes enters the market, it's right below a PaaS, but above some of the custom tooling most people have been building. So it takes this very opinionated approach. Everything must be a container. You must have a declarative config. And it just has a way of thinking about the world. Now, as you start to mature, you're bringing in a new audience. So now you're past the early adopters. So the biggest challenge is most people look at Kubernetes and says, well, it looks very familiar to how I was doing things before. So we spend a lot of time trying to make the new thing work the old way. So if you have an existing investment in a security tool that you bought, maybe it's a logging tool that you bought, you may want now the community to stop and integrate with everything. And anywhere you don't see a proper integration, then you may say, well, Kubernetes isn't mature. Or you may say, it's not quite ready for my use case because I can't change everything. So I think that's where we have a healthy tension going on. So if you're used to doing load balancing one way, and out of the box Kubernetes assumes one thing, that's just going to be a lot of friction for you. And if you don't know what the fundamentals are, you may mistakenly go and get some really immature load balancer just because it supports Kubernetes. And it may crash and it may not be mature. So I think that's where we just have to be a bit careful. That's the biggest thing. No one knows what they don't know.